Hello guys, let's try Cycles X. Here we have a scene for a villa, and as you can see that it's quite simple, just an empty scene because I tried multiple scenes, even benchmark scenes, and sometimes Cycles X just, or Blender 3 does turn off or crash. So I've actually tried this scene multiple times and it works fine for the purpose that we make a little benchmark using quite nifty hardware. And we have two things. We have RTX 3090 and AMD Ryzen's Threadripper. Okay. And there's no ambient occlusion, there's no bevel nodes whatsoever of the materials. So I think that will be a good scene to test. So we will test first the speed, rendering speed, and then we test the feedback. So let's try this out. First, here is the scene, control enter. So we can control enter because I'm industry compatible, not because it is in Blender shortcuts. So you may find me saying weird things. So as we can see here that we have a tile that has a pretty standard approach. But I think that we need to increase the tile size a little bit to match the capabilities of the GPU that we are using. But the CPU here, as you know, doesn't like the large tiles. So it may be a little bit slower. So here we go. We will find that the tile of 3090 is quite obvious here. It is getting the 128 samples. Quite low number, but it does the trick. It will show us the actual speed. Does Cycles X in this quite early stage is a big deal, or we still need to wait? So here we go. We will wait for the render, so I will skip that. Render finished at 338. Well, not bad, but let's see if Cycles X will do the same, or it will be something really quite fast. So just before we go to Blender 3, we will go to the rendered viewport and see the performance, general performance. I really love how Blender performs in the viewport. And as you can see, that's the base of sampled post tracing. This is how it looks. But here you can see that it is quite neat, and it has the denoising feature and really cool. I really love it. Not bad at all. So nice. Let's see Blender 3. Here we go. We have opened the Blender 3, and as you can see that we don't have tile size anymore. So if we started rendering right away, F12, because this one is Blender standard keymap. Let's see what will happen. Okay, here we go. The scene in the other version was rendered in about 3 minutes. Hopefully it doesn't take too much in this one, because it seems it will. So we have here 7 samples till now. And there's no tile size because there is no control about that. So we will have to wait. But let's make sure that we have the proper settings first. So we will go to edit and go to the system. Okay, it's CPU based. What you have seen is just the CPU alone. Let's see optics. I don't know if optics does work, but let's see. Let's see. Okay, let's start. So that was the speed of CPU. It wasn't the GPU speed. Let's start and hopefully it doesn't crash. Alright, I think it will start. Okay. Whoa! Whoa! It jumps like hundreds of samples per second. Okay, 512 samples. It wasn't 128, it was 512. I just known right there. And as you can see that we are rendering progressively like all renderers in the world. And we are almost about to finish the image. 35 seconds. Let's wait for it to finish. I think it will finish about in 1 minute and a half if things are going okay. And I feel that right now. It really renders so fast. Just don't blame me about the UV problems and all that stuff, because this scene supposedly it's not finished yet. It is being tested. It's just a test scene, because I didn't find a scene that doesn't make Blender 3 crash except this one. So that is why even the benchmark scene, some of them does crash the Cycles X for now. But I think that the really amazing, it finished in just 1 minute and 25 seconds. Whoa, that is more than 50%. It's like double speed. And as you can see, the image quality is the same. Exactly the same samples. And it rendered in half of the time, and we are just in the early stage. Really, really astonishing. Let's see the feedback of the scene itself. Hopefully it doesn't crash. Hopefully it doesn't crash. Okay, it started. Way to go, man. Let's edit first because I'm a Mac user, old Mac user, so I'm really used to. Whoa. But I feel that the denoising, it doesn't work. It doesn't work, actually. The denoiser, it's turned on, but it doesn't work. Okay, let's keep it every 5 samples so it does work. I think it is not implemented in optics yet for some reason, but the feedback is astonishing. Whoa. Feedback is quite fast. There's no sluggish, it's just the flashes. If you have seizures, it may affect you a little bit for bright scenes, but wow, quite fast. It has really a big difference right now. What if we just waited for the official release of this? It will be a bomb in its 3D industry. Before we end this video, I want to tell you something. Want to earn and support the channel in the meantime? Here you go. You can register for Cryptix, and this is a crypto mining application that gives you the opportunity to give an affiliate link to your friends and earn up to 5% off their earnings, not from their earnings. They don't lose anything. All you need to do is go to the description and sign up for Cryptix, and you will have your money earning wheel running. And to try out Cycles X, all you need to do, download experimental branch, and you will find it here, experimental branch, and you go to Cycles X branch, and here you go, you can download it right away. And thank you for watching until we get into another video for new stuff about architecture. See ya.